My crepe myrtle branches have these long, thin things coming out of them. They look like small, dried out twigs. This has been going on for about 3 weeks. What is going on? And this is from Ms. Suda right here in Memphis. So, Mr. D, I see you nodding your head there.
Yeah, it's an ambrosia beetle.
It's ambrosia beetle
damage. That's what it is. Gets on, it'll attack lots of different plants. Prefers stressed plants, but it will also attack healthy plants. Mm-hmm. But the insect bores into the stem, and the little tubes that you're seeing is actually frass.
Yes, frass. Yeah.
They're pooping out. And the insect is interesting because it cultivates the fungus inside those tunnels. And it's a symbiotic relationship between an insect and a fungus and a fungal organism. And for that reason, the systemic insecticides don't help you because
they do not work.
The insect is really not feeding on the plant.
That's right.
Fortunately,
and that's a common question we get, Mr. D. It's like, well, can I use, you know, imidacloprid? And I tell them no, because again, the beetle is not consuming plant material, just excavating out, you know, those tunnels, and that's it.
Yeah. The thing that you need will give you some help. There are some products that are labeled to use on it. Once they're in the plant, you know, there's not a lot you can do about it. Mm-hmm. But if you can, at the first sign of attack, and it's usually in the late winter when the plants are just about to come out of dormancy, is when you first begin to see the signs, you can treat with permethrin, it's Astro, Perm Up, and others, Dursban, but you have to use a higher rate. There is an ambrosia beetle rate.
Wow.
Again, read the label.
Yeah, read the label.
You've got to go a little bit stronger rate. And then Onyx and Onyx Pro are, and this is out of the Red Book, late March or May, late March through May, or when an attack is seen is what you need to do. Yeah. Again, if you use any of these products, read the labeling.
Right. And the thing about the fungus that you were talking about, I think it's fusarium fungus. It's a pathogenic fungi. It actually clogs up the xylem vessels. So, of course, we know by xylem, it takes water from the roots to the upper part of the plant. So when that's clogged up, then guess what?
It can kill a plant.
It can kill a plant.
Yeah.
It can kill a tree.
We hope you loved the video. We would love for you to ask more questions. Be sure to leave those questions in your comments.